Hello, welcome to MTN. My name is Jordan Gibbons, I'm senior reporter, and we're here at the bike shed to ride the brand new 2018 Honda Monkey Bike. Now, this is sort of our halfway point for the day. We set off from the Ace Cafe a couple of hours ago. We've been riding it all through London, and we're just going to spend a couple of minutes now. You can see that, you hear what you think of it, and you can get to know the bike a bit more. Here I am, just sort of riding along the embankment. And it's just like riding any other normal 125, really. You know, you might look at it and think, oh, it's a bit of a joke. And it sort of is. It's a bit like a little clown bike. You know, people sort of point and laugh about it. I laugh at it myself. But it just works with getting on the bike. There's no sort of horrible foible that, you know, that you would expect it to have. It's not that it's only got, you know, no power, or the brakes are terrible, or the suspension's rubbish, or the fueling, anything like that. It runs and rides just like a proper bike. I mean, the suspension is tiny. I can only assume that Honda have been trying to save money by using biro springs in the stanchions. But all that aside, it works really well. They're really smooth. One of the things that's really smart about this bike, apart from the sort of tininess of it and everything else, is it how it works as a normal bike. So in this particular case, it's got this tiny, tiny little fuel tank. But because the mile per gallon is so outrageous, I can't remember off the top of my head, but it's about three figures. Oh, come on. Yeah, it's about three figures. It means you get about 240 miles out of the bloody tank. I mean, just ridiculous. You know, and for sort of scooting around town, especially if you only live a few miles from work, you only have to fill it up twice a week. It'll probably cost you about £6. So one of the things this has got, apart from very good brakes, is that it's got the IMU from a Fireblade, so it means that if I absolutely stomp on the brakes like that, you can pull it up really quickly. And one of the things you think is, why has it got the IMU from a Fireblade, or more specifically, why has it got the Bosch 9.1 Plus ABS? Well, that's because this thing weighs so little, and the wheelbase on it is so short, that if they didn't, because the brakes are quite good, you'd basically just endo it or stoppy it everywhere that you go. I think it'd fit in between this Ford and this. I mean, considering it's only got, you know, whatever brake horsepower it's probably got, probably wouldn't surprise me if it's single figures, maybe just about double. It's really flighty. Especially around town, I mean, I'm not going to easily keep up with this courier. This is the fastest I've ever ridden in London in my entire life.
The Monkey, it's just shy of £4,000, but it's £3,699. So it's a little bit more than the MSX 125, the Grom, as it's probably better known that it's based on. But it's just so much cooler, in my opinion anyway, that it's definitely worth the extra. Over the sort of, you know, that retro cool that it has is just so much better than that, I think anyway, than that sort of like weird futuristic sort of madness that the Grom is. Although don't get me wrong, the Grom definitely has its fans. And you know what, as well, like all modern manufacturers, there are a couple of finance options available, including a PCP deal, which is just £65 a month, or you can buy it on hire purchase for £100 a month. And, you know, it's much better than a bus pass, isn't it?